We have booster ignition and liftoff of Columbia, reaching new heights for women X-ray astronomy.
The main thing that Chandra does is take these superb dark images.
Nothing as beautiful as Chandra sailing off on its way to work.
Humanity has long sought to learn about the Milky Way, our home galaxy. Even after the advent of optical telescopes, the Milky Way's center, some 26,000 light years from Earth, remained mysterious because gas and dust blocks most visible light along our line of sight. Fortunately, X-ray telescopes, like NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory, can detect higher energy radiation that penetrates this veil of galactic debris. Dr. Frederick K. Baganoff of the Massachusetts Institute of Technology has been using Chandra to study our galactic center for several years. He explains why X-ray telescopes like Chandra are so crucial for this pursuit.
X-rays are important for studying the center of our galaxy because the Milky Way, our galaxy, is a spiral galaxy. And that means it has this sort of frisbee-shaped disk and then a bulge in the center. And in the disk are lots of dust clouds. Because our sun is in the disk, we have to look through these dust clouds to see towards the center of our galaxy. And the dust acts like smog and it blocks our view. So we actually can't see the center of our own galaxy in optical light or ultraviolet light. You can only look at longer wavelengths like radio and infrared, or the shorter wavelengths like X-rays and gamma rays.
What does Chandra see when it looks at the heart of the galaxy? It finds a sea of hot gas enveloping thousands of white dwarfs, neutron stars, and black holes. Chandra also finds regions aglow with the light of massive young stars. And that's not all. At the very core of the Milky Way lies a supermassive black hole that has a mass of nearly 4 million suns. This black hole is named Sagittarius A star, or Sag A star for short, due to its location in the direction of the constellation of Sagittarius. Sag A star is continually growing as it pulls in gas. Infalling gas is heated to millions of degrees and gives off X-rays, which have been detected by Chandra. Sometimes gas outside the black hole can become superheated and expelled from the region at millions of miles per hour. Fred Baganoff explains how Chandra has been used to observe Sag A star as it erupts into flares.
We looked at Sag A star with Chandra in the first year, and we saw pretty much just this quiescent level of emission. It was a low, steady source. And the next year, in 2000, we looked again. All of a sudden, in an hour and a half, it increases by a factor of 45 in X-ray luminosity. And then in 10 minutes, it dropped by a factor of 5. We were able to use the fact that it dropped by a factor of 5 in 10 minutes with the fact that the speed of light is constant to figure out the size of the region that it was emitting these flares. And the size of the region is about 10 times the radius of the event horizon of the black hole, the event horizon being the point at which even light can escape. So this X-ray flare was coming from a region only about 10 times that size. And that would be equivalent to about the Earth's orbit around the sun. That small of a region was producing all of this energy.
What do scientists think caused these outbursts from Sag A star?
There are two possibilities. One is that a lot of extra mass was suddenly just dumped on to the accretion region. Second hypothesis is that it's more like a solar flare. Solar flares are related to magnetic fields. And so the second possibility is these X-ray flares were produced due to magnetic energy being turned into acceleration of particles.
Clearly, there is much to explore and learn about our home galaxy, the Milky Way, and Chandra will continue to be an important tool in that effort. For more information about the Chandra X-ray Observatory, visit our website at chandra.harvard.edu.
This was a production of the Chandra X-ray Center, Cambridge, Massachusetts. NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center manages the Chandra program. The Smithsonian Astrophysical Observatory controls science and flight operations from the Chandra X-ray Center.